We talked previously about how some genetic mutations can have a higher propensity for cancer. And we want to continue talking about the genetics field, but we want to talk about a specific form of genetics known as epigenetics, which is the study of gene expression changes without any changes to our actual DNA. And that can be a little confusing, so let's break it down. If we look at genetic mutations, that's where we have an actual change to the base pairs on our DNA. That can be shown depicted here in red. So our DNA that doesn't have any changes will make RNA, and then that RNA will make protein. However, the DNA that does have genetic mutations would make mutated RNA, and then those proteins that it makes would also be mutated. However, with epigenetics, we're only looking at our non-mutated DNA. However, it varies in the amount of RNA and protein that is produced. And we're going to use two specific examples to describe this. The first would be how our DNA is packed on histones. And histones are proteins that hold our DNA because our DNA is very long. And you can think of this almost like string that's wound up in a ball. It's able to hold onto it very tightly and compactly. But when it's held so compactly, the proteins that need to actually read our DNA are not able to interact with it to make RNA and then proteins. So therefore, it's not produced. But if those histones loosen up that DNA, that allows the proteins that are needed to come in and read that DNA to make RNA and then more proteins. So that's one form of modifications on how we can increase RNA and further protein production just by some slight changes to how much that DNA is tightly bound on the histone. The second modification would be looking at something known as methylation, which can happen along our DNA. Now, methylation can happen on base pairs of our DNA, and as the proteins that are reading our DNA to turn it into RNA are moving along, they come in contact with one of these methylations and they stop. Therefore, RNA production is halted. However, there have also been studies that show that some forms of methylation are able to attract those different proteins that need to read our DNA to make RNA, therefore making more RNA. So those modifications don't actually change the DNA, but they change how much of that DNA is read and the quantity of RNA that is made from it. Now, epigenetics combines genetic and environmental factors, and it understands how cells differentiate. So you can almost think of this in as an analogy as DNA being the blueprints, but epigenetics is how we read those blueprints. Now we have all the instructions in front of us, but sometimes we need to read certain parts multiple times to understand it. Some parts we can skip because we understand it completely. So make sure to stay connected with my channel and with Dane Garvin as we continue going over various genetic concepts.